I've always said that I would love to go back and cycle the Balaclava Pass again. Now that I'm more into cycling, I'm fitter. 11 years since I did it back in 2013. I've also wanted for a few years to raise some money for a local mental health charity. So I thought, well, why not combine the two things? So I've been cycling for about 12 years or so at this point, which is really interesting because I was always the kid in school who always forgot his games kit and PE kit. I had no interest in sports or fitness or anything at school. And then in 2012, or a few guys from my church had started a bit of a cycling club, and they asked me, did I want to, you know, get a bike and join them? So I thought about that. Now, for context, I am the sort of person that picks up a new hobby, gives it a go for a couple of months, and then gives up on it. That's just who I am. So I was a bit reluctant about spending a couple hundred pounds on a bike if I was going to give the hobby up after a couple of months. Thankfully, I didn't. And I've stuck at it, and 12 years later I'm still cycling. I do remember going out for those early rides just after it started, and I'd go out for, you know, 5 miles, 10 miles, maybe 12 miles at a push, and I was completely busted, completely cooked after those rides. So a little bit of encouragement, if that's you right now, maybe you're just starting out cycling and you're riding low distances and you're thinking, how am I ever gonna ride bigger miles? Well done for starting. Keep at it, just stick at it. The fitness, the mileage, everything will come in time. Morning. So after I'd been cycling with these guys for, you know, a couple of months, they said to me, oh look, here, we're going on a cycling trip to Scotland next year. Do you want to come along, come and join us for this trip? I just said, yeah, sounds good, why not? I'll come and join you. Didn't ask about where it was in Scotland, didn't ask about the distance, the elevation, like didn't know to ask any of that stuff. So yeah, sure, I'll join you. Fast forward a year and I find myself at the foot of the Balaclava Pass near Applecross in the Scottish Highlands, and it is a climb that goes from sea level to just over 2,000 feet above sea level in about 3.5 miles. Now bear in mind, I've been cycling for maybe a year at this point. I'd never done anything of this scale. I already had that day 70 miles in my legs by the time I got to the bottom of the pass, and then after I got over the pass I still had another 25 miles to do. So yeah, that was a bit of a baptism of fire, but you know what, I will remember that trip for the rest of my life. It was actually incredible, it was unbelievable, just such an unbelievable experience. But it's also, as I think back on it, it's also tinged with a bit of sadness as well.
that it's kind of tinged with sadness as I look back is because my friend Davey, who asked me to join the cycling club in the first place and was responsible for me getting into cycling, was the guy who organised that trip. Unfortunately, he sadly died from suicide a few years later. Davey's death impacted a lot of people, and I can't speak for anybody else, but it certainly impacted me quite significantly. For the few years following since then, I've had my own kind of challenges and difficulties with my mental health, whether that was grief or kind of stress and anxiety and occasional sort of low mood. I have kind of since then struggled on and off with my mental health. One of the things I've done to support my mental health is sought out a professional counsellor, and I have gone through counselling on a number of occasions, because being able to talk to somebody is vital, is really, really key, is really important. But another thing that is personally for me really helpful in maintaining good mental health is getting out cycling, getting out on the bike. Whether that's on my own, just to clear my head, or whether that is with my cycling club or a bunch of friends, cycling for me is hugely beneficial for my mental health. It's almost like a meditation for me. It's one of the only times in my day and my week when I'm single-minded, when I'm focused on just one thing. I'm just focused on cycling. When I'm on the bike, I'm thinking about my average power, I'm thinking about my speed, my cadence, what's my navigation, where am I going, all that kind of stuff. So I kind of become almost single-minded on the bike, and I'm just thinking about cycling. And that's kind of the purpose behind meditation as well, is just to clear your mind and have that focus. And I do get that on the bike. So for me, getting outdoors as well and getting out in the fresh air is hugely helpful for my mental health, and doing that on the bike is brilliant. So I'm really, really grateful to Davey for introducing me to cycling all those years ago, and I'm still sticking at it. Okay, so that's a little bit about my cycling story, my cycling journey, how I get into cycling, why it means so much to me, why it's important for me. So what's next? Well, I've always said that I would love to go back and cycle the Belaknaba Pass again. Now that I'm more into cycling, I'm fitter, I'm, you know, 12 years since I did it back in, no, 11 years since I did it back in 2013, and 10 and a half years since I did it back in 2013, I would love to go and try it again and see if I'm faster. I would need to be faster up it. But yeah, I'd love to do that again. I've also wanted for a few years to raise some money for a local mental health charity. So I thought, well, why not combine the two things? So this month, May, is Mental Health Awareness Month. So towards the end of the month, I am going to cycle from home here in Northern Ireland all the way up to the Belaknaba Pass. So over the course of, I think, 4 days and about 400 miles or so, 380 miles maybe, I'm going to cycle and bikepack my way to the Belaknaba Pass. Day one is from home in Northern Ireland up to Ballycastle, where I get the boat to Port Ellen on Islay. From Port Ellen on Islay, I get the boat to Kennacraig on the Campbelltown Peninsula, and from there I cycle to Oban. Day two, I cycle from Oban through Fort William up to Invergarry. Day three, I cycle from Invergarry up towards the Isle of Skye, then turn north and head to Strathcarran. And day four, the final day, will be a loop from Strathcarran up over the Belaknaba Pass, round the Applecross Peninsula and back to Strathcarran. And then I'm not cycling home. Day five is a day spent entirely on trains and boats getting back to Northern Ireland. Why am I doing it? Well, you've heard my story, and I want to raise some money for Aware Northern Ireland. Aware Northern Ireland is the main depression charity in Northern Ireland, and they do loads of good work for mental health in Northern Ireland. You can read a bit more about them on their website, but they run support groups, they run awareness sessions, they run mental health first aid training courses, and I would love to just raise some money to support the work of a mental health charity in Northern Ireland. There is a Just Giving link in the description of this video, and if you go there, click on that link, you can go to my Just Giving page and you can make a donation to the work of Aware Northern Ireland. I would really, really appreciate that. Just to be clear, I am self-funding this trip, so I am paying myself for my travel and my accommodation and all that kind of stuff. all the money you donate will be going to Aware Northern Ireland. So yeah, I would love if you could just spare a few pounds and help me raise £1,000 for Aware Northern Ireland. That would be wonderful. I'm going to leave the video here, but I just want to finish by saying, if you are struggling with your mental health, if you're finding things tough, please, please, please speak to somebody. Trusted friend or your doctor or somebody, but if you're finding things tough, please speak to somebody. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate you watching this long video, but I appreciate even more if you can make a donation at the link below.